यस भावना,
मैम प्रियंका इज अबाउट टू जॉइन, देन यू कैन फॉरवर्ड।
कैन वी हैव योर वीडियो प्लीज? भावना
यस मैम,
कैन वी हैव द भावना भाटीज वीडियो? शी हैज जॉइंड ना,
जस्ट गिव मी 2 मिनट्स मैम।
I think you have joined from Ruchika's iPad, right?
Oh yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
You are Bhavna, na?
Ma'am, both the IDs are.
Ruchika, ma'am.
Huh?
मैम भावना सिंह एंड भावना भाटी, बोथ द आईडीज आर माइन।
अच्छा, सो कैंडिडेट इज रुचिका, मुझे लगा कि ये वाला कैंडिडेट का है। ओके, सो हाय डॉक्टर रुचिका।
हेलो मैम।
बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद, कैन यू ब्रीफ मी अबाउट यू?
Ma'am, I am Dr. Ruchika Mohan. I have secured an All India rank of 75 in INICET July 2021. And I have been a TND student at TVMCI.
Okay. All right. So you were like from Delhi only, na?
Yes, ma'am. I have completed my MBBS from VMMC, Delhi.
Okay. So, wow. Congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So, Bhavna, is it good to go? We can start? Dekho ek bar.
Yes, ma'am. Good to go.
All right. So, hello, everyone. And again, we have Renka with us, Dr. Ruchika. She has got an amazing score of 75 in the INICT 2021. So, hi, Dr. Ruchika. Welcome.
Hi, ma'am.
Heartiest congratulations for such an amazing score that you have secured.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Yeah. So first of all, I would like you, Dr. Ruchika, to introduce yourself and tell us about you, how you have been associated with us.
I have completed my MBBS from VMMC New Delhi, and I have been a student of DBMCI. Since 2020, I have been a TND student for DBMCI.
Okay, all right. So, Dr. Ruchika, this has been an amazing score, double digit 175. But I think this is even more special because you managed to secure it in this, unpredictable era. Things would not have been same for the people who had secured these ranks before. And I think those who have been will be securing in the future, because these years has been, typical. They were unpredictable, and time was obviously not good. Pandemic era and a lot of negativity around. So I think it's really incredible that in spite of so much of negativity, unpredictable conditions, so many of cancellations and postponements, I think when INICT got postponed just 2 days back, I was literally in shock. And students were messaging me, ma'am, what to do next? And I was saying that I am in complete blackout. I do not know what to answer to these students. So I can completely, relate with that condition. So what is your key to success? Like, how did you manage in all these times?
Ma'am, actually, in usual case scenarios, when we appear for exams, the main thing is how do you manage a hectic internship with your preparation? So in that case scenario, what matters is an early preparation. But in this case scenario, the major hurdle was that since the time span had been increased to 6 months, almost like all the students had completed all their subjects. And therefore, I personally felt, even while giving the tests and everything, that the competition was slightly on a higher scale, because the problem of managing time with the preparation, that thing was not there this time. It was rather difficult for those who had completed their preparation to maintain those things, and to it's like there's a peak in the preparation. So what is difficult is to maintain that rather than to attain that peak.
Yes, you have been very correct in this. Like, this was a year where the people who were on the higher node of preparation were towards the negative side.
Yes, ma'am.
And the people who were having the less time with the lesser of the, preparation were getting more and more time. And so the gap was reducing. I think that was a positive point for those ones. Yes, yes. So how did you manage then to maintain your pace, to get rid of all this negativity? At times you must be feeling low also, I suppose, because, it's not easy to maintain that plateau phase every time, and, ups and downs always comes. So how did you manage with that?
Ma'am, actually, first thing was very clear that it was a do or die situation. It was almost like a drop year when you have an exam at such a length of gap, and since there was no scene of NEET also being conducted, so there was no option of giving up or losing hope. So it was like, you have to do it this time only, or it's like never. So that was the key thing, that there were no second thoughts that I have to do it or I don't have to do it. And the key was that after a certain point, you realize that no matter how many times notes you read, a particular score cannot be improved, no matter how hard you try. Like, I have read my notes repeatedly, but there was a point where the rank and marks got stagnated and they were not improving. So therein comes the role of test discussions and all the extra stuff, which helps you overcome that, because those extra thing, then that edge can only be given by those tests and discussions, and all the extra that YouTube sessions and everything which are being conducted by the institute.
So how much, you know, importance you will give in your preparation and getting such a score to this test and discussion that you're saying ki, after you reading your notes, you always tend to get stagnated, because cover to cover notes will remain the same. If you want to get a higher level, then you have to do something extra. So was this extra was supplied? It was efficiently done by this TND?
Yes, ma'am. Definitely it was done. There's no doubt in it. And you need to attend TND. There is no way out of it, because notes is something that right now almost like all the participants, if 2 lakh students
everybody
are sitting in exam,
everybody has access to those notes.
Yes, ma'am. And after coming of all those printed notes, there is hardly any factor of that writing notes and all the hard work. Mm-hmm. So you need to do something extra if you want to get a rank. So definitely TND are a must. Without that, there's no going ahead.
And how much TNDs were efficient to maintain your schedule? Because, you know, once you have done with the reading of the notes, I think one major factor is that how to maintain your pace doing the revision of all the 19 subjects. So does preparing the TNDs according to the schedule which they gave also helps you to maintain that 365 perspective doing all the subjects in the given time?
Yes, ma'am. Definitely, ma'am. Because most of the TND, they are conducted in a manner that your first revision would be completed by August or March by September 1st week. So that is like the ideal time to complete the first revision. And it's like almost 99% of the students have not read the notes thoroughly up till final year. You read textbooks, you read your notes, but that thorough revision, you need one complete revision. And for that, that scheduling is very important, and TND is like the perfect schedule which you can follow. The time distribution, the syllabus distribution, it is very wisely done, keeping in mind the workload at the internships and how it can be completed.
So, because yes, you mentioned about your internship, how did you feel that how the staff and the Delhi office, head office management did cooperated with you maintaining your schedules along with your internship?
Even without your mentioning, this was one thing which I have always wanted to appreciate about DBMCI. It is the most student friendly institute. Like there were times when that GTs are conducted for which you are supposed to register beforehand. So there were times I used to keep procrastinating that I'll register, and then suddenly it's the day of the exam and I realize I haven't registered for it. So there's Devay sir and all the academic team. Like, you can message them any time of the day on WhatsApp, on email. And sometimes I used to just casually message them ki, it's okay if I get a reply, I'll give the test. Otherwise, it's okay, I'll give the next one. But they used to reply within like 5-7 minutes and with a new ID password that here you can give it. So this is one of the things which is very, very unique to DBMCI. It is the most student-friendly institute with respect to the faculties and obviously with respect to all the technical staff as well.
Yes, I think here even Anu ma'am needs to be mentioned, because she takes special care of all the Delhi students that mere bachcho ka wo nahi hona chahiye, like time waste nahi hona chahiye. She is like having a motherly feeling for all the students out here. And even mujhe bhi wo personally bahut baar bolti hai ki please manage kar lo ma'am, students ka wo classes hai ya students ki posting hoti hai, and we faculties always obviously take care of that. So she is very, very, you know, careful and sensitive about the students.
Yes, ma'am. When I shared my rank, she specially messaged me personally, and it's something good that a person at such a higher position is acknowledging such small things. So it shows how humble they are.
And no, it's not a small thing, Ruchika. No, ma'am, we are as excited as you. And one thing I wanted to tell you, that even we are more excited than you. What happens, you know, you have worked hard, you knew that you have given that paper and within that limit, you, up to your expectations, you are getting your rank. But we have been waiting for this so long. And, you know, you people by bringing these scores have, you know, given us so much proud feeling. I cannot tell to you, like, before an hour only, we were having the mega session with all the rankers. And I cannot tell you, I can see that sparkling in every faculty's eye because we had been also waiting for this long. It was not just your aspirants. You know, waiting period. It was a waiting period for the faculties also. We were also, you know, feeling helpless that our students are suffering, dates are not coming out, how to manage their schedule, how to motivate them. You know, it takes so much of courage to motivate for a cause for which you yourself is not motivated.
Yes, ma'am, definitely.
So amazing, very good. Anything that you would like to suggest to your colleagues, to your juniors, and for those students who have been will be appearing for the NEET 2021, like what will be your personal message, some do's and don'ts which you can tell them from your experience?
Ma'am, for NEET, I like to suggest that since the time span is limited, approximately a month or 40 days are left. So my advice will be, or on a personal note, which I would have done would be, for the subjects for which you have read the notes once or twice, and you are a little confident that from your perspective, that subject is done, one should go for a retrograde approach and should practice questions from that subject. And for the subjects which you're not confident with, so for that subject, doing notes is must, because at least you will not mark the basic questions wrong, which most of the students get right.
All right, I think a great message. And because, you know, the students who have not fared that well or who are not satisfied with their ranks are looking forward for a much bigger paper NEET. And I think they are actually looking forward for your you people's whatever suggestions and improvements you can give. And you are the people who can give them real experience. Like, we tell them according to our experience, but you are the people who are telling just from the, you know, horse, they are listening from the horse's mouth. Yes, I did this wrong, please don't do it. Or I did this worked for me, you can also try that, right? So can you tell me something about you that you feel like everybody studied? As you said, that notes are same more or less with everyone now. So what is that one extra thing that you did that you feel give you that edge over the others and you could perform so well here?
Ma'am, I feel there should be a few subjects which should be your strength that will give you edge over the others. So I had few subjects like anatomy, surgery, microbiology. In these subjects, I had done extensively. I had read them in such a way that I used to revise a part of it. Then next day, I used to revise the part I read the day before, and I used to move forward. And I have done this many a times for these 3-4 subjects. So at the end, they were these subjects. I knew that if a question comes, if I don't know, nobody will be knowing the answer to these questions. And then there are subjects that are weak. So you have to accept that those are your weak subjects, and you have to have that faith in yourself that maybe your strong subjects might cover a question or two. So I think that has been a major helpful factor for me, that I had few strong subjects and I worked hard on them, so that actually everyone has a quality. Like some people can integrate well, some people can, they can keep things in mind for a longer time. There are subjects that require repeated reading, that required strong recall. So I have a strong recall from the beginning. Like, so I worked on that quality, and these are few subjects which need a very strong recall. So I tried and made them my strength till the end. So that helped me a lot.
So means knowing one's own strength and weakness and realizing them, that yes, these are my weak subjects and these are my strong subjects, is pretty important. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So what about the ophthalmology? Like, this is a personal question. because, you know, whenever there is a list of volatile subjects, Ruchika, I think ophthalmology always comes first, and students always named it at the top that, yes, ma'am, ophthalmology is a volatile
Almost one. Like everyone, opta is the most tough subject at a undergrad level because we are not exposed to it in any way.
Yes.
It is like all together. And even today as an MBBS graduate, if someone asks me medicine for X and Y conditions, I may able to give some answer. But for conditions of ophtha, I'm like a total blank. I don't know. So yes, definitely it has been my weak subject. Ophtha was my weak subject and I have worked a lot on it in the last 3-4 months. I have read like the notes 3-4 times for ophtha in last 2 months.
Oh, all right. That is the thing. Actually, when I take the foundation batches or I take regular batches, I always say that, see, for me, you people are same, because every time, whether I receive the third years or final years, yes, now, their ma'am. Level of confidence in ophthalmology is always same. So I will start with the very basic and only then I'll reach to the top. And
yes, ma'am, that is where the role of coaching and teachers come, because if you pick up Khurana, you are like lost. Even during the prof, it was so difficult to remember those 10 topics also. They mark very ultra short list of 10 topics. And those also become like those history answers which you have to buy hard, because it's all just, you know it or you don't. There's no concept over there.
Yeah, actually, now for making the concepts, you need to see those things, perceive those things.
Exactly.
And at the UG level, you don't have any idea where do you have that timbre and segment. So how do you, know that what is hyphema and hypopyon when you do not know the anterior chamber?
Yes, ma'am.
And that is why I always see I require the same number of hours for both the batches, because, you know, I will have to start from the very beginning. And they are same, yes, whether it's foundation or it's regular, right? So, did you attend the ophtha TND?
Yes, ma'am, I attended ophtha TND on the app. We had lockdown in March, so all our TNDs were taken on this all thing. Right. E-Gurukul. Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Okay, so you attended that. Okay.
Yes, ma'am, so, I attended like almost all the TNDs.
Okay. So, would you like to mention any faculty, any particular subject, anything else you want to say?
Ma'am, I'd like to specially mention Dr. J. Arora and Ashwini sir. I've been following them for not just the TND, but I attended their classes in my final year as well. And both of them are amazing in their fields and there's no parallel to them.
Yes.
So I really like to mention them. Apart from that, obviously the TND is very good. All the faculty is very good, but those two teachers, since I've attended their classes, so I'd like to personally mention about them. And even during, I have asked doubts from them in the last few days. So they have been very helpful. And the way they teach, they make things very simple. They are one of the most tough subjects if you do not know the right way to deal with them.
Certainly. Okay. So... thank you so much. I think students who are watching this interview will definitely get enlightened, and the thing that we wanted to share, what you should do and what you should not do, because in the last 40 to 45 days when we are there for the NEET PG 2021, I think the most important thing is not only what you should do, the thing is what you should not do also, because that is also extracting the time thing out here. So I would definitely say that you will gain, the students who are watching will gain a lot of mentoring from these students who have come up with such a good scores in INICT. Thank you so much, Ruchika. Once again, heartiest congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
And wishing you all the very best in your future endeavors too. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.